Hello there. Welcome to Straight to the Point. Today we are going to create a simple spiral staircase in AutoCAD. So without any delay, we just begin. In order to create a spiral staircase, we will need to know the width of the walk. So a spiral staircase in standard, it's going to be something around 24 inches, and a standard height is going to be around 7 inches, 6 to 7 inches. So for that, in the drafting and annotation workspace, we will first create one circle of based on radius, and we'll take the radius of this to be something around 2 inches, and then we create another circle in the midpoint and we create the radius of 26 inches. So the main length or width of this stair will actually be 24 inches. For convenience, I just will move it to somewhere a little here. Now, it's time to divide the stairs with some lines. So I start creating a line and do it till the end. Well, there are some extra pieces, so I will trim it out. Say TR for trim, double enter, and delete all the parts we don't need. Now I need to array this line around this small circle for around 12 times. So I'll say a polar array from here. Take the line, press enter, take the midpoint, and here is your array. The number we change to 12 and press enter. Close the array. Right after that, we will have to break this whole thing because the array object is a whole object. We will need to completely break this. So in order to do that, I will take the explode command, select the arrayed objects and press enter. Now all my objects are separated. Until this much, once we have done, we will need to add this entire structure to a separated layer in order to secure that. So I go to the layer properties and just create a simple new layer and rename that to shapes. Close that. I will select all my objects, bring this pull down and simply select the shapes layer so that all the objects are secured. Now, in order to create things, I will go back to layer 0 or whatever layer I am into. Maybe I create another new layer and I call that boundaries. Double click that here in order to select that as a current layer. Now whatever I am doing right now is going to be in the boundaries layer. Now it is time to create the basic 2D shapes for one step, or maybe each steps. There would be 12 steps altogether. Remember, everything here is actually an individual shape. In order to create the boundary out of all of it, press BO on your keyboard in order to access the boundary command. Press enter. It will open up this dialog box. Pick points and click on the midpoints of each surrounded zones. Keep clicking, and here are all the boundaries been picked up. Now press enter. Here if you see the message, created 12 polylines, and they are actually full polyline objects. Here comes, if I just hide this shapes, now you will actually see your boundaries are completely here. They're separated objects. Now, since we are done this much, we are about to create one more thing, which is going to be the handrail. The handrail will be a little less radius than this 26 inch outer radius. So I'll just start creating another circle. The base part would be, if I started from this center and start creating the circle of around 25 inches, it would be somewhere over here. And now, in order to create the railing rods in the middle of the staircases, we will need to create one small circle in this midpoint. In order to do that, I will need to find out any one length of this, or one small slice of this entire area. For that, I will be trimming all these extra parts of this handrail. In order to do that, I will trim TR, double enter and delete these two pieces, and rest of the part I can easily delete. Now this small piece which I have now have a midpoint, so I can go create another small circle in the midpoint. Remember, if you do not find the midpoint snapping, just make sure in the snap section your midpoint is turned on. Now just start creating a circle, and I might just get it around 0.5 inches of radius. Now that small circle, once done, I can now delete this reference line. Now this small circle I will be arraying exactly 12 times around this small one. So I say the polar array back again, select the small circle, enter, take this midpoint, enter, and here comes the number of copies, 12, and here we go. Close the array. Remember, just like always, I will have to break this guy also, this entire railing array too. So I take the explode command and select the railings and press enter. Now they are all broken and single object. Now it's time to move back to our 3D view and go for some 3D extrusions. Press and hold shift and drag with your middle mouse in order to rotate your view and see the 3D orthographic or isometric view. But in order to change your workspace to 3D, just click on this gear icon and change from drafting annotations to 3D basics. It will take a little time to reset the whole interface and workspace in order to change or get your 3D commands available. Now, I will be extruding all the shapes I have done. So what I will do is, I will take the extrude command. The first thing I will extrude is all these railings, because that would be easy. So I select all of them, press and hold shift and deselect all the other things which I don't want. Now press enter. The railings height I will get 2 feet. So I will simply enter 2 feet. In case it doesn't work for the 2 feet, it will simply be 24 inches. Here these things are extruded. Now I will take the extrude command once more and take all these shapes and extrude them for 6 or 7 inches. I'll take it 7 inches. That's it. So everything is 7 inches extruded, and everything is extruded the way we want it. In case you want to see the shaded view, simply go back to your 2D wireframe here, the visualization section, and take the shades of gray. It will show you all your 3D things out here. Now it's time to simply move all these objects, all these railing objects, little up, like 7 inches. They have to be over the steps. So I say M. It would activate the move command. In case it doesn't, just wait for it, or then simply press M and enter. Select all your railing objects, press enter, make sure your auto mode's on, click anywhere and pull it up for 7 inches. It would be exactly 7 inches up. Now it's time to move every step and every railing adjacent to it, exactly snapped to 1 step up, so that it makes steps. In order to do that, I press M, enter, select 1 step and 1 railing, press enter, start from this snap point, pull it up to this snap point. I would keep repeating this process for all these rest of the steps. Here we go. All the stairs have been placed right on spot. So it's pretty much done. Now it's time to create the handrail. In order to create the handrail, I'll have to go back to my drafting and annotation space once more in order to receive or access these splines. I will take a spline fit. But before that, remember to turn on your 3D snapping, and I will turn on center of face in order to access or snap all these spline fit to the midpoints of each railing. In case you do not see this 3D snap button here, just click on this customize sandwich button out here and your 3D snap settings will be available here. Just turn that on. Now, since I have that, I will simply click that and I make sure my center face is turned on. Now I take this draw menu down and take the spline fit. I click in the midpoint of every midpoint faces of these railings. In case your snap is going for this auto mode on, you may initially turn that off. Sometimes this auto mode is kind of disturbing, so you can turn that off, and I just keep clicking all these things in the midpoints of these faces. The railing or the handrail will automatically be initialized there. Once the final one been clicked, press enter in order to finish. Now the handrail's path has been fixed. Now it is time to create the profile. You can create different profile. For the sake of the chapter, I'm just creating a simple circle based profile. I start from this snap, the center face, and I make the radius to be something around 0.8. It's just a little big. Now in order to make this exact handrail in a 3D, I will be using a 3D command called sweep. In order to do that, I will go back to my 3D basics workspace. Here is the sweep command. Take the sweep. First take the profile, press enter, and then click on the path and your handrail is automatically created. You can create custom profiles with the help of, instead of creating that small circle, you could create that so that the handrail would have been a little more designer. Once that much is done, our staircase is almost there. In order to just get this area filled up, I might take one small sphere and start it from the midpoint, and the radius I'll put it something around 0.9, just a little big. The same thing I will do on the top. Take the sphere, start from here, and the radius goes 0.9. That's it. Our spiral staircase is almost there. Thanks for watching. Many more quick and to the point videos are coming up soon. Feel free to share your comments on the content. If you like the process and want to learn more, stay tuned with Extreme Universe. Have a nice day. Signing off.